I dreamed of launching a startup and getting my $10 million so I could buy a luxury car, buy a house and spend more time with my family. That's why a few years ago I invested over 180k and two of the most productive years of my life in creating a SaaS product. How did it turn out? It ended up being useless to everyone. I went bankrupt. I had to face my failure. After that, I tested more than a dozen different micro SaaS ideas and successfully launched three of them, which just a month after their launch are already bringing in 2,500 on autopilot. In this video, I will share 5 things that you have to avoid to make your SaaS profitable from day one. Let's go. In 2018, I spent 2 years and over 180k creating a DJI video streaming SaaS. I wasn't a newbie in software development. By that time, I had a highly profitable software development agency and I knew how to build SaaS products. But the problem was that I focused too much on developing the platform instead of quickly focusing on the video streaming feature and making fast sales. My mistake was that while all the clients was excited and love our product, nobody was actually buying it. In the end, I burnt out, and as a result, the following 2 years, even for my software agency, went very poorly. What I realized is that even if you have experience in development, it doesn't give you the right to spend a long time creating your product. Anything longer than 2 weeks is already a failure. The best product for your users should look like a button. Press me to solve your problem now. A user should only have to do 3 things on your service. Understand what problem you're solving, pay, solve their problem. Only this way you will get a correct feedback about your product, because if you haven't received payment, it means you didn't solve your user's problem. You just created a nice design. So, no user profiles, no dark mode, no refunds or anything else until you start making sales. Only when you see those first sales, then you have a legit permission to add or change features in your product. The most important skill you need to obtain is the ability to get rid of all unnecessary features. For example, in my case, it should be just a video streaming feature on iOS using a third-party service like Vobza. That's it. Even without Stripe payments, because it can be replaced with a manual invoice. Now, when I launch a new micro SaaS product, I can easily ignore webhooks that inform me if a subscriber is unable to pay after a year. It's no longer a concern. If no one buys the product, there is no risk of anyone unsubscribing or not paying in a year, right? If they do make a purchase, then it gives me the motivation and resources to add the necessary features. It's so simple. Next, marketing. The biggest trap is falling into the cycle of an unfinished product. This usually happens for 2 reasons. First, you know that feeling when you have to add more and more features because you're unclear about the core value your product provides. Second, as a software developer, you might simply enjoy coding and hate to step outside your comfort zone. I feel you. Been there, done that. Remember what I mentioned earlier. You need to become a full-stack entrepreneur. Your front-end is marketing and your back-end is coding. Start accepting this new reality. Start learning and implementing marketing strategies right now, just as I did when I launched this YouTube channel, which already brings me tons of software development requests every month, so I can easily decline 90% projects that I'm not interested in and give me lots of new leads every day for my Micro SaaS Fast, Design Fast 2, my personal consultations and others. So before creating an MVP, you should already know your target audience, their main pain points, and have their clear. Yes, we are ready to pay for your service now. With this clarity, it will be easier to formulate your offer on your landing page. Keep in mind that your users will never see and use your product if the offer on your landing page is bad. So the landing page offer should look like the result that users will get first, then by using what, basically your service features, and then at for whom this service. That's it. Please always spend twice as much time on marketing rather than on coding. I remember when I launched the first version of my consulting website, I had a generic headline. I later changed it to a request a CTO brainstorm and immediately integrated a calendar iframe, which increased my conversion rate by 50%. So use always straight to the point marketing strategy and philosophy. Guys, if you want to learn more about Micro SaaS AI monetization and lead generation and ask your questions during live chat, please click like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Next, you're spending way too much time on your MVP trying to add more and more features. Features obsession will lead you to a bankruptcy, like me. You're not special, sorry. So what do you need to do to launch your MVP quickly? First, open your VS Code, Cursor AI, or any IDE you prefer. Create a new Next.js project using this command, npx create next app latest. After that, we will go to ChatGPT 01 Mini and create the following prompt. Next, we just need to copy the code and paste it into our VS Code. Remember, ChatGPT 01 Mini is much smarter than Claude AI, but Claude AI is faster with simple questions. Now, you have your AI agent's MVP ready, which you can test and modify for your niche, your client problems, and your routine. You might ask, how do we handle payments? It's simple. For the first MVP stage, you don't even need to write a payment system. Just go to your Stripe account, click Create, and set up your payment product or just a one-time payment URL and send it to your customer. If they pay, then it's time to add Stripe to your MVP. If not, then you need to improve your Micro SaaS MVP core functionality. You can also use no-code tools. It's a legit tools, but the entry barrier is much higher now compared to AI plus code things that I've showed you right now. Remember, only 0.5% of your visitors will pay you anything. My Micro SaaS conversion rate is between 0.2 to 0.4%, so be realistic with your expectations. Also, if you want an immediate ready-made wrapper for creating your Micro SaaS that already includes a landing page, a user dashboard, email setup, AWS, payment setup with Stripe, SEO, and many other things, you can use my Micro SaaS Fast, which will help you launch your Micro SaaS in 30 minutes or even less. If you want to save time and move quickly, just use it. One-time payment, link in the video description. By the way, do you know what a real MVP should look like? I launched a Micro SaaS Fast and was waiting for my first purchase. A few days later, I saw a successful payment on Stripe, but there was no email from resend confirming that my customer had received access to the GitHub repo and all necessary information. So I manually wrote an email to my user, did everything manually, and then fixed the bug. The issue was with an incorrect webhook URL on Stripe. So if you're afraid of failing, do not be. You can survive and even earn some money along the way. Pricing. The most important lesson I learned from creating my failed DJI video streaming SaaS is that you should always charge your users upfront, and preferably for annual subscription. Our first client, who was involved in construction inspection, purchased a $800 annual subscription with ease. But my problem was that I didn't research the market, as other services were comfortably charging from $1,500 to $30,000 per year. Remember, there is no venture capital fund or World Bank behind you, and you can't afford to give your product away for free or at a low price. Price is never the key factor. My strategy in any business is always what I can do to set my price at least 50% higher than my competitors. By the way, another lesson from the DJI video streaming SaaS experience is that some businesses ran away from us when they found out our service cost $15 a month. To them, it seems too suspicious. So, if you want to get that endorphins rush and motivation boost, always set your prices high right from the start. Take my Micro SaaS Fest as an example. Before finalizing the price, I thought, what amount would make me feel excited? 100 bucks? No. 150? Nope. 250? Yes. I settled on that price point because it motivates me. When I received my first 250 bucks, I felt happier. Then I made my first million on Upwork. I do not know how it works, but it was a great feeling. So, to get that dose of happiness and motivation, always price your product between 100 and 300 bucks, either as a one-time payment or an annual subscription. Skip the monthly plans and focus solely on annual ones. This approach prompts both you and your customers to ask the crucial question: will I be using this product next week, next month, or next year? Your goal is to provide such value that the answer is always yes, making the price less significant. Later on, once you validate your product, you can introduce various pricing models like subscription-based pricing, tier pricing, or token-based pricing, among others. By the way, if you want to learn more about Micro SaaS and join the community of solo entrepreneurs, follow me on X, where I host a live chat with my audience and help them launch and monetize their startups. Next, fail fast and learn on the go. Creating large products can lead to significant negative experiences in case of failure, resulting in fatigue and depression that are difficult to recover from. The 5 years I spent avoiding new opportunities is a great example of that. Time is the only resource you can't get back, so always start small. Avoid building massive projects that require huge resources. In my case, I knew how to build large projects and had a good partner, but it still didn't work out. So try to create a Micro SaaS in just 1 to 2 weeks. Launch it, see what happens, and then move on. This approach allows you to fail quickly, multiply times, helping you better understand SaaS, SEO, marketing, coding, your users, and use that experience in your next tries to make a profitable business. I've highlighted this in all my videos, and I'll repeat that again. Build a system for a quick Micro SaaS launch and create as many as possible, and start today. See you.